WWE legend Edge potentially just had his last ever match on SmackDown in Toronto, in a first time ever match against Sheamus, in what was a bittersweet moment. Edge cut a promo after SmackDown went off air with his family at ringside, basically saying he doesn't know if he can do this anymore, and that he needs to go back and think about it with his family. The emotion that us wrestling fans felt watching Edge's last match, which was a banger by the way.
Banger! After banger! After banger!
Really got me thinking about the influence that Edge had on my love for pro wrestling. As a kid, I absolutely despised Edge. And one of my early memories of Edge was a random episode of Raw in 2006, where him and my hero at the time, John Cena, were going at it backstage, and they made their way out of the arena, where John Cena actually threw Edge out into the ocean. Edge was always feuding with my favorites as a kid. Whether that was his legendary feuds with John Cena, or one that I really remember well, was his rivalry with The Undertaker. I just remember the build up to their WrestleMania match was just so entertaining and so damn good. I actually remember watching their WrestleMania match as a kid and just getting so frustrated because every time The Undertaker would go for one of his big moves, Edge would just counter it over and over. Edge really knew how to get a crowd against him during this time in his career. I personally don't know a single kid growing up back in the day that actually liked Edge. I hated Edge so much so that one year I begged my parents to buy me an Edge action figure just so I could beat the hell out of him for myself. I don't really think I'm doing it justice just how much I hated this man. But in saying that, everybody deserves a second chance. And just as Edge was in his character arc, just as I was starting to like Edge, probably due to the fact I was getting older, it all came crashing down. As we all know, Edge was forced to retire due to neck injuries. And I just remember watching the promo, you know, the promo, and thinking to myself, there has to be a swerve. There's no way this is happening right now. But with tears in my eyes, I listened to Edge explain how he had to retire and that we may never see him again. I, for one, never expected an Edge return. It seemed impossible. It seemed like it would never happen. But then, it's the 2020 Royal Rumble. The clock starts counting down and we hear.
Who's it gonna be?
You think you know me?
The emotions that were felt in that moment as we saw Edge make his historic return to the squared circle was unmatched. It's honestly the loudest pop I think I've ever heard, and rightfully so. We saw Edge full of emotion perform his entrance and enter the Rumble as he was back. Edge had returned after 9 years. The impossible was suddenly possible. From hated to loved, from villain to hero, the story wrote itself with Edge. And honestly, no feeling could come close to this. Sitting in my room at 4 a.m, watching the pay-per-view live and in awe of what I'm watching. The nostalgia running through my veins as we see the reuniting of Rated RKO, even if it was only for a brief moment, because we all know how that turned out. Look, the point I'm making is the story of Edge is one all about emotion for me. Not about the historic matches, not about the Canadian destroyers he's amazingly pulled off in his return, but the emotions he's left us fans with. The joy, the anguish, the relief, and now this odd, bittersweet feeling. This may not be the end for Edge in WWE, we don't know just yet, but if it is, I'm damn happy that we got to see him go out on his terms, in front of his hometown and on SmackDown where he made his name. All there's left to say is, thank you Edge.
Rated R Superstar!